Hello, it's me, Adrian, again, and I've got a thing to show you. This is a trippy little hack that I've used in the past to split out a date time value in a column to the individual int values of the year, month, and day to use for grouping within a report. This is, again, just a little weird hacky thing that I've done in the past. I'm not saying that this is something you have to do, but it's another option in the tool chest to build out report tables and things like that. So check it out. All right, so today what I want to show you is how to take a date time field in Postgres, and by proxy, Hasura, and split out the date time field to year, month, and day. This is useful if you're trying to like group the fields by those particular values and you don't want to put date parts in there, or you just want to have those separate values for other pertinent reasons. There's a lot of different reasons to do this, but we're just going to focus on getting it done here today. So if you go out and you navigate on the web to this particular repo, github.com/Adrian/GraphQL relational concept mapping, you'll be able to pull down the repo where I have this full example working that you can pull up and build out on your local machine using Docker Compose and check out these examples yourself. All right, so once you've cloned it locally, just pull up a list. And you'll see you have the standard pieces of the repo plus blog entry and Hasura. Blog entry is pertinent to what we're talking about in this video, which is a blog entry I put together, but also Hasura has all of the migrations, metadata, and seeds that we'll be using for this example. If you do a Docker compose up-d, you'll see things start just as is being done by this starter.sh script. I've then typed in Hasura console to bring this up, and I'm taking you now through where I have the column set up, where sign up date is the column, the date time column itself, which also has timestamp. If you add that, it's just a general Postgres timestamp. And then there's year, month, and day, which are the int values or text specifically of the date part of the sign up date here. And you can see that I pull as the default just using the now function, which would pull the immediate time that the record is inserted. At that time, then, it would pull and execute the date part function for each of the values of that particular date part from signup date into each of their own columns. So here you would get year, then month, and then day. And also note, in the user interface, the way you would add that is default with date part and then year, text, and then signup date, where it shows that with the particular syntax. And again, go check out the repo for the exact syntax, just so you can kind of copy and paste. All right, let's navigate back to the repo, then into the Hasura directory, the migrations, and then the migrations directory, click on the data part peripheral file directory that has the up.sql migration. And in that, you'll be able to see the SQL you need to be able to do the exact same thing in Postgres. Do note, in this file, there are several specific differences versus what you see in the Hasura interface. In the Hasura interface, it appears as a default that is set using the date part function. In here, we actually are setting it in the SQL as generated always as, then the date part function set to stored. And the same thing for month and day. And that is how you do a date part split out to different columns using an existing column and new columns to split that date out in your database table.